Breaking news this morning, Fiat Chrysler says its former CEO, Sergio Marchionne, has died. For more on Marchionne's life and legacy, we're joined by Rebecca Lindland, executive analyst at Kelley Blue Book. Rebecca, great to have you with us.
Thanks. Good morning, Melissa.
In your view, what was his most enduring mark on the company?
Certainly his ability to run 5-6 different companies at any given time, his ability to master these incredible deals and at the same time motivate people and you know, make people feel so important. If you were talking to him, you had his full attention. And it's a shame that he didn't get to master his final deal of some kind of, you know, big merger with another manufacturer. But it's an incredible, incredible loss and just really, really tragic for everybody and certainly for his longtime partner and his sons.
Do you think that what would have been that final chapter, engineering a deal to sell Fiat Chrysler, do you think that's off the table? We got a statement yesterday from the largest shareholder, Exor, that they are committed to the company remaining independent. You got this new guy coming in, Mike Manley, and new CEOs in general are not apt to sell the companies they just took the helm of. And he also came from Jeep, and so you think maybe a spinoff of Jeep, maybe that's off the table too, because he probably wants to hold on to that asset where he cut his teeth.
Absolutely. And keep in mind that Mike Manley has been running Jeep for the last number of years very, very successfully. He also took over the Ram truck division. So he's very much an insider, very much one of Marchionne's lieutenants. I don't think that the company is looking for a merger anymore as much, a spinoff. I think that the alliance that they have with Waymo for autonomous driving and autonomous vehicles is another sign of Sergio's mastery in terms of understanding what to invest in. You know, this is a company that's so much more healthy than it was when he took over in 2009. And so he's leaving behind an incredible legacy for both Mike Manley and for others to follow. So I think one of the things that's really upsetting to me is just what would he have done in retirement? I wanted to hear him speak more freely. You know, once he was out of this role, I wanted to read the books that he was supposed to be writing. And we've just all been robbed of an incredible, incredible person.
Rebecca, where does it leave, the company in the sense of a company that straddles two continents at a time of a trade war when you have huge exposure to the North American market and trucks that are protected by, by 25% tariffs. So how do you navigate this right now? What would Fiat Chrysler like as an outcome to a lot of these trade negotiations?
I haven't spoken to a single manufacturer's executives that don't want the trade wars to go away. There's nothing good that comes out of these tariffs. I think that one of the things that Mike Manley will have to look at is Fiat in the U.S. They've only sold about 8,000 units in the last 6 months. I mean, that's what, you know, Toyota sells a Camry in a minute practically. So, you know, we've got to look at some of these brands. They have to figure out what to do with Chrysler, which, again, may be able to continue on the alliance with Waymo. That will be an interesting story to follow. But nobody's winning with these tariff wars. It's just something that isn't helping anybody and certainly not saving American jobs.
Yeah, and we'll be listening for all of that on the earnings call today. Rebecca, thank you. Rebecca Lindland of Kelley Blue
Thanks.
Book. Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.